Thanks, A. I'm at the Portuguese Sports Club where the party for Paul Pernarewski has just begun. He's declared victory to become Waterbury's next mayor. Unofficial results from the Pernarewski campaign show that he defeated Republican Don Majorano by about 600 votes. Again, those are unofficial, but Paul has declared victory tonight, and we're lucky enough to have Paul Pernarewski with us right now live on Channel 3. Paul, great to see you. Congratulations.
Thank you.
I'm wondering what this was like for you as you're at the back table over there with your team counting the results, seeing them come in live. What was that like?
It's a little nerve-wracking. You watch the precincts come in and come out. We're up a little, we're down a little, we're up a little. So it was an anxious time, but it worked out good for us in the end, and we were able to come up with the 600 votes we needed to win. So
600 votes, tighter than you thought. What did you think this morning?
Yeah, I mean, you know, when we were doing our poll standing today, I thought, you know, it felt better than the 600 votes, but it was clear that Dawn had a lot of support out there as well. So, it is a win, and it just means that we're going to have to work harder to bring people together here in the city of Waterbury to face the challenges that we're going to have to meet over the next few years.
You mentioned to me earlier, Dawn called you about an hour ago. What did she say?
She just basically said, you know, that we had a sufficient number of votes to win, and congratulations, and that she was, available to be as helpful as we thought she could be, and she was willing to do, be helpful in that regard. And I indicated to her that I appreciated that and that we would probably talk, so I think it'll be helpful.
Top issues that we've talked about the last couple of weeks in Waterbury: crime, economic development, education. How do you improve on those things in the Brass City?
You know, I mean, we're going to continue. There's a lot of development that's in the early stages here in Waterbury that we've been doing. We're going to continue to build on that, the downtown redevelopment, brownfields. Education, we're really going to drill down on. We've got some great programs and some kids who do really well in the schools, but a lot of kids who are not making it, and we're going to drill down on what we can do to get them to really succeed in school. And I think a lot of that is going to be, how do we get their families, their caregivers more involved in it? And crime is, what we do know is it's a lot of the crimes are being committed by the same people over and over again. It's a small number of people committing a lot of the crimes, so we've got to work with the legislature on how we can get those people off the street. And also make sure we have sufficient programs for young people to keep them from getting involved in the first place. So I think it's a two-pronged approach there.
It's the first time in 12 years the name Neil O'Leary hasn't been on a ballot for mayor in Waterbury. How do you improve on what he's done?
You know, he's done a great job, and I'll be the first to say that I think he's one of the best mayors that we've had in Waterbury in my lifetime, if not longer. But I think, you know, we've brought the city, Mayor O'Leary working together, we've brought the city to fiscal stability, and it's in a good place. So now we have the opportunity to build on that and to really focus on things that we haven't had a chance to focus on. So that's what my goal is going to be, is just take that time, take the work that we've done now and the platform that we're on, and make sure that we can do the things that we need to do to move Waterbury to the next level.
Paul, thank you. Congratulations.
Thank
and good
you.
Luck. Stephanie, we'll send it back over to you.
All right, Dylan. Thank you.